Thank you to my dear colleague, Senator Paul Richards. Guest of honor, Mrs. Sharon Rowley. Members of the Diplomatic Corps. UN Resident Coordinator, Ms. Strana Kazana. Hope I got it right. Mrs. Nicole Flynn and her mother, Catherine Primrose. Dr. Stacey Blackman. Members of the Down Syndrome Family Network, Chairman Glenn Niles and the Board of Directors, Conference Chairperson and Honorary Board Member, Mrs. Lisa Ghani, sponsors, representatives, boys and girls, members of the media, ladies and gentlemen. I feel especially privileged to be able to join with you once again as we celebrate the annual Down Syndrome Family Networks Conference in commemoration of World Down Syndrome Day. This year's theme, End Stereotypes, resonates with the human rights approach to persons with disabilities and advances the goals set forth by the United Nations Convention on the Rights of Persons with Disabilities. In the preparation of this greeting, some statistics was brought to my attention, which not only startled but frightened me. I was told that in the United States, nearly 70% of babies prenatally diagnosed with Down syndrome are aborted. In England and Germany, that figure climbs to 90%, and in Iceland, nearly 100% of babies conceived through no fault of their own with that extra chromosome are aborted. Sadly, they are not eradicating the condition, but they are eradicating the people. As I look around the audience today at all the smiling faces and the hearts that I know are filled with nothing but love, I thank God that I live in Trinidad and Tobago. And I thank God for persons like Glenn and Lisa and persons who advocate for persons with Down syndrome to ensure that the rights, liberties, and freedom of persons with disabilities are protected. World Down Syndrome Day is not a day only to celebrate persons with Down syndrome, but a day to spread awareness and to help dispel misconceptions, many of which are unfortunately publicized by persons circulating outdated and incorrect information. The celebration of World Down Syndrome Day is an opportunity to change attitudes, to champion inclusion, and celebrate the gifts of those born with extra love, extra smiles, extra trust, extra empathy, and one extra chromosome. It is an opportunity to start seeing people differently, seeing their talent, skills, aspiration, and their dreams. The truth be told, the value of a human being, your intrinsic value and mine, is not dependent on our social status, our physical beauty, mental ability, or any worldly feature. God created all of us, and we are all worthy of love for that reason. Unfortunately, our brothers and sisters with Down syndromes are not always treated with the proper love and respect that they deserve. I can assure you, my friends, that we at the Ministry of Social Development and Family Services will not be voiceless, nor out of tune in the defense and promotion of persons with disabilities. We will not lack the words, and above all, the tangible gestures for encountering and welcoming persons with disabilities. It is for this reason that in our new corporate headquarters, for which I turned the sod recently with the Honorable Prime Minister, particular attention was paid to ensuring that the building is accessible to all persons with disabilities and all our facilities contained thereof are of similar stock. I am equally happy to see that other ministries and government agencies are creating and implementing policies, services, and programs to ensure that persons with disabilities are able to stand side by side with the persons who do not have disabilities. The National Library and Information Systems Authority, NALIS, signed an MOU with the Trinidad and Tobago Blind Welfare Association to make thousands of books available to persons who are print disabled, visually and hearing impaired. Only on Sunday as well, my cabinet colleague, the Minister of Sports and Community Development, closed an adaptive physical education workshop in Tobago, which trained persons to work with athletes with disability. As Trinidad and Tobago moves to become a more inclusive society, we must learn to overcome the discomfort and fear that we feel at times towards persons with disabilities. We must learn not only to seek, but also to intelligently invent appropriate tools so that no one is left behind. Persons with disabilities help us to recognize, to accept, and promote in each of them the incomparable value of resilience, strength, determination, and hope that is embedded in each of us, created by God. At the ministry, our primary mission is to provide support to the most vulnerable sectors of our national community, including individuals with disabilities. In pursuit of this mandate, we highly value and actively cultivate strategic partnerships with both public and private entities, as well as advocacy groups. It is through the great work of our NGO partners and stakeholders, such as the Down Syndrome Family Network and other organizations, that the ministry has been able to extend its reach to provide assistance to persons with disabilities. And we thank each organization for their valuable input over the years. In recognition of World Social Work Day, which is actually celebrated today, the ministry and other social workers throughout the country, we recognize their work. They work diligently to help persons with disabilities and ensure that they are protected and create opportunities for their development. So I speak to social workers today to let them know that their work is appreciated and valued. We remain steadfast in our commitment in achieving the United Nations Sustainable Development Goals, with a particular emphasis on addressing the needs of individuals with disabilities. World Down Syndrome Day offers a significant opportunity to spotlight the sustainable development goal that promotes inclusivity, rights, and well-being for individuals with Down syndrome. Specifically, SDG 10, Reduced Inequality, which calls for substantial efforts to diminish the disparities faced by those with Down syndrome and other disabilities. In this regard, organizations dedicated to advancing these goals play a pivotal and indispensable role in ensuring that no one is left behind. So therefore, I must commend Down Syndrome Family Network for their unwavering commitment to supporting parents and caregivers of individuals with Down syndrome, significantly enriching the lives of those within the community. Your efforts are perfectly aligned with the ministry's goals and objectives. And our ministry has collaborated closely with many organizations, particularly also Down Syndrome Family Network, where we participated in previous conferences, body walks, and lots of socks promotion. You consistently demonstrate your capacity to raise awareness and deliver impactful support to individuals with Down syndrome and others' disabilities. Additionally, this organization stands as one of the primary NGOs advocating publicly for legislation aimed at promoting and protecting the rights of persons with disability. I couldn't speak here today without speaking about legislation. Recognizing the urgency of legislation specifically aimed at protecting the rights of persons with disability, the ministry is actively expediting its legislative agenda. And consequently, an initial draft of Trinidad and Tobago Disabilities Bill has been formulated, with ongoing revision efforts currently underway. We have solicited and received invaluable recommendations from various stakeholders, including 18 government ministries, 3 statutory bodies, 10 non-governmental organizations, and also persons with disabilities. And these recommendations have been meticulously considered, leading to amendments being incorporated into the revised draft bill. We recently sent our draft bill to the Law Association of Trinidad and Tobago, the Equal Opportunity Commission, and the Tobago House of Assembly for their comments. Furthermore, the ministry's internal legislative review team has undertaken a comprehensive revision process, including a comparative analysis of disability legislation across jurisdictions, regionally and internationally, ensuring that the resulting bill meets or exceeds international best practice and standards. The ministry is nearing completion of the final draft of the revised bill. The bill will undergo the requisite legislative drafting process, be submitted to the Legislative Review Committee of the Cabinet, and then for the approval of the Cabinet. Noteworthy provisions of that draft bill include, but are not limited to, protection from discrimination against persons with disabilities, access to education, the right to work and employment, access to health care, access to housing, access to auxiliary social services, the right to adequate standard of living, and the establishment of the Trinidad and Tobago Council for Persons with Disabilities. So, ladies and gentlemen, I encourage each and every one of you to use this year's theme as a clarion call for a wider and more sustained action. I urge you to remain steadfast in our collaborative efforts to challenge and eradicate stereotypes regarding the capabilities of individuals with Down syndrome and all persons with disability. So today, I ask you to remember an occasion when you felt excluded, so you can help build a community where everyone is included. I thank you, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. Rock your socks. May God bless you.